Hello everyone and welcome back to another episode of Total War Warhammer, continuing our Chaos campaign, which, ooh, that's loud, as we spoke about last time, is not going super well. We're trying to hang in there. Now we're going to see if we can make our comeback. Sarthoriel, the Everwatcher, has been defeated, which is good. So, the traitors have been dealt with. Now it's just a matter of survival. Survival. I guess I'm running kind of a cost-efficient army. Still, if I can just get 2 units of knights, that'll be enough to hold up against most things. As we march back across the land and prepare for further battle. Alright. Sure, that'll increase my income, so. Yes, the Storm of Chaos does gather. And worry not, Archaon, I will be sure you unleash one hell of a storm that they won't forget. Upgrading your horde buildings is kind of the only way to get additional income. So really, the Isling are our number one opponent at the moment. And probably the number one threat to our survival. Oh, we can get Manticores now. That's right. That'll be nice. That'll give us something that will hunt down those pesky Marauder units much quicker. And we have the Gaze of the Dark Gods, which helps us a little bit. Do supernatural prowess. And our sorcerer of death is leveled up. Let's give him power drain. I think it's time I made my presence felt. Because to say that I am angry is rather a gross understatement. The Norskins have all betrayed me and thought I would not notice. And because of their betrayal, I've had to retreat to the north. So I think I'm going to make an example of them and put every single one of them beneath my heel. It's just a reminder of who owns them. I think it's only fair. For those of you who care about other things going on, we are just about ready to start a tabletop campaign that I'm very, very, very excited for. It's going to be a Blood in the Badlands campaign, so basically we have a little tile map designed to resemble the, everything about the Badlands. And what the campaign's about is about us trying to conquer the Badlands while also taking a flying fortress designed by the infamous Fozzik, which if you don't play tabletop, you probably have no idea who Fozzik is. But if you play... if you do play tabletop, he is the same individual who made Fozzik's folding fortress, but this time it's Fozzik's flying fastness, so it's a flying fortress. All together. We're gonna set up on this hill. Alright, how many... He's got a couple of Marauder Horseman units. It's fine. I can use Archaon to harass and force them towards me. Because they don't have any wizards, and I do. Hope you're all doing well. From what I hear, things are stabilizing in the world a little bit. At least I hope. Fire. There you go. I hope it makes it over that curve. Yeah, it will. Not as good of a shot as I would have liked. I'm just gonna keep bombarding them. Chosen, I want you up on the hill. Keep vomiting fireballs because I can. And that spell takes fucking ever to go off sometimes. Down right into the thick of it. Shields up. Oh, wait. Okay, just chill out over here. I got this. I forgot I had this. These, a lot of the new units I have access to could help pull the chariots back out. Archaon's winning his fight. The exalted champion against this guy. Activate all the heals. Infernal Gateway. You don't have that spell, bro. I wish you did, though. If we get the Lord of Tzeentch, I better damn well. Okay, run away. Ah! Trolls are scary. hand. They're mass breaking. Chariot saved the day. Alright. Vengeance! That is one of many Norskan places that is going to get completely and brutally slaughtered by me. And we lost 51 troops. That's not bad at all. Really good kills across the board. Chariot did really well. I need to move that. I guess I'll leave that Nurgle mark for now. Of course, Archaon taking like zero damage and just beasting his way through enemy units. Like the tank he is. Alright. Oh, God, it's worth nothing to me. I'll take the growth, I guess. Get out of my way. You're growing. Yeah. Well, let's make you like a proper champion. Then I'll worry about the next step. The good news is I don't have to break too many places. I think the Isling are like one of the only tribes up here still. And I have quite a bit of help in taking them down. Recruit a hell cannon? I would if I could afford it. Where does this territory end? Oh, there. So we're gonna heal up. I'm gonna try and make him come back to life at Doomkeep, but we'll... Oh, it's Kislev. That's who's helping me. I see. I probably should chase him out of here. Still in friendly territory as I head towards them, so. This is it. This little group of land right here is all that's left. And once I get fully healed, I think I'm going to end my alliance with... Wait, where are the Varg? I don't see any Varg settlements. Varg? Oh, they're down here. Okay. So, I will wait until I've only got one place left to deal with. Battle of Grayling Moot. Actually, we're gonna leave that guy as my ally. No, we're not. No, because he'll probably end up fighting my vassal. Because he can declare war on my vassals. He just can't... Is that how it works? I think he can declare war on my vassals, which is the problem. Y'all can ride with Archaon for this. Now go scout. So many annoying units. At nights you walk, Archaon, just to get going. You're my only pseudo-invincible dude. Why are you guys walking? Let's go. I kind of think I should probably trade out my Chosen for Warriors, but I guess we'll play it by ear. Start firing off fireballs. Go kill that general. That was a pretty good shot. Go kill that general, because ain't nothing nobody can do about it.
Thank you.
go knights. Alright, Archaon is impacted. Alright, boys. Spread out wide. Start melting some of these units. Chariots, let's ride! Get a little buff. Chaos chariots! Die. Pull out. Pop this. Oh, shit. I hit my own exalted hero like a dunce. Oops. Part of his army's holding up so well. Oh. That part. I'm gonna keep burning this crap down because I got better things to do. Alright, they're mess breaking. Another settlement bit to my will. Eric of the Cool and Ivar Slaughterborg. Well, now you're Ivar Deaderborg. But yeah, anyway, so for the Blood of the Battlelands, I gathered together those of my students and friends who know how to play tabletop, and we're going to play a campaign for the first time. And I'm gonna make a separate video all about that, but I'm just telling you guys because ooh, hello, money. Because I'm really excited. All right, he is full level. So I guess I will. I kind of want to put it. I think I want to learn both of these spells to give him a little bit more of a range. All right, and I'm gonna pick up. Oh, these are the Marauder Horse Masters, huh? They have really good armor. Wow! Not as fast. They're much better. What's their range? 84, so that's the highest range. So I'm gonna pick up two of those. Then I want a Hell Cannon. And another unit of Knights. Hopefully we're making enough money now that we'll be able to sustain that. Those horsemasters are really good for their price. Alright, one of these two is probably going to destroy Doomkeep. Or not. Make me look dumb. That's cool too. Alright, so the horsemasters are worth barely anything upkeep wise, which is good. Come on, somebody destroy Doomkeep. I will not join in. Yeah, no, you're not getting peace. Did he lose? Yeah, he did. He thought I was gonna help him. I've got better things to do than help you, bro. I'm gonna break these guys again. We may be allies, quote unquote, but I'm not interested in being your bud. And the only reason I'm picking up an extra unit of knights is just because with Archaon's Swords of Chaos buff, my knights are, like, stupid amazing. We took so many casualties against them. So these are the Marauder Horsemasters, which are actually, like, kind of scary-looking Marauders. The highest tier Marauder unit, in fact. Oh, Cannon, if you would do the honors of inviting them over. I will form up beside you. I do kind of wish the Hell Cannon had its tabletop stats sometimes, but then I remember how much I hate fighting Hell Cannons in tabletop, and I think, never mind. Which, if you're not familiar with Hell Cannons, so lore-wise, a lot of people don't understand this about Hell Cannons. Hell Cannons are not just war machines. They are basically demons that have been forced into, thanks to the demon smiths of the Dawizar, or the Chaos Dwarfs. They are creatures that have been stuffed inside of these immense machines. And because of that, a lot of the people, or a lot of the Hell Cannons are actually designed, because they're basically demons in iron, they actually have, a lot of them have like claws and these big gaping mouths, but in tabletop, those actually hurt you. Like, they actually attack you. And it's very, very, very scary. Alright, let's see how these guys do. In fact, I'm gonna send the knights over here to help overwhelm. I actually like that they changed the graphic. Alright, so let's turn this off, chase them, and the knights are gonna butcher the hounds. In we go. Chariots! My regular troops, forward! To Archaon's aid! Fired those. Boom! Fire! Oh, I think I activated his potion of toughness and I did not mean to. Alright, they dealt with these. Y'all deal with the warhounds. Oh, wow, they have not that much ammo. Oh, wait, okay, I see what happened. Alright. I love chariots. Chariots have become one of my favorite units in the game. Really and honestly, they're just so fun to watch a solid chariot charge. Meanwhile, Archaon fights like a total boss. Did buff my army earlier. I caused terror. Alright, yeah, this is all working really well because my guys are like practically immortal. The exception of this guy who's getting there. Alright, how am I doing health wise? Alright, I'm back at full. So yeah, I would say the takeover of Norsca is going quite well. And these Marauder Horsemasters I think may well have a future in this army. I like that they have the longest range. They're not quite as fast, but they also have good enough combat stats that I feel like if they get caught, it's not like the end of the world. But we'll raise this one, and then I will turn my full attention to Doomkeep. Alright, you're level 12. Oh, right, you're only a hero. My bad. You're level 5, though, so thick-skinned, and let's do... let's do thick skin hard to hit. I want to make you more defensive than offensive.
Alright.
There's a chance he might just take Doomkeep, which would be kind of annoying, but we'll deal. I'm hoping he fails. Yeah, he did. Okay. Can I even... Wait. Can I make it here in one move? No, I can't. Alright, so I'll stop in friendly territory. And we will upgrade this to level 5. Which is good, because I need to really quickly get the one that reduces my upkeep. I think we have a building like that. Ooh, Beastman. Near here? Oh no, down here. So, I kind of want to forge alliances with the Beastmen.
My tribe is open.
See, if you're willing to become...
Diseased dogs! Present yourselves so I may put you out of your misery.
Yeah, they're not very helpful. Yeah, I haven't actually met any of the Beastmen yet, which kind of sucks.
Have you dead. All you.
Well, we're getting there with the Greenskins. If I can forge an ally out of the Greenskins, I'll actually be in a decent spot. Okay, so we wait this turn out, getting fully healed, and building up once again. Man, I'm gonna whack the shit out of him when I catch up with him. Who is that, Dimitri? Yeah, it's Dimitri. Alright. This will be the final battle against the Isling for the entire campaign. There's no more betrayals. See, if I had realized... It's been so long since I played a Chaos campaign, and I didn't figure out how to do a good job of submitting or forcing the Norskins to submit until, like, way later. And I did not remember, or know, one of the two, I'm not sure anymore, that the Norskins actually will betray you when Sarthoriel comes out. I thought they remained on your side and that only he betrayed you, but instead they all turn on you instantly like a bunch of jerks. Which I did not appreciate. Look forward to when I can actually finish designing this army the way I see them in my head. We're getting there. Is that everybody? That's everybody. Oh, they're just out of range. Okay. Good. I'm gonna give them a nice... Maybe those Marauder horsemen. I don't really care about regular Marauders. They're too easy to kill. Alright. I kind of love the way those fire, in that they're like really slow but deliberate. Oh shit. Bell's acceleration is not that great. We're just gonna run away. It's raining magic. Actually kind of hard to swivel and shoot. Alright, I'm going to turn my attention back to the Norskins. Alright, this group we can easily overwhelm. Knights! Chariots, and Halberdiers, and Death Wizard. Archaon, let's go. Oh, I get their attention. You have fun with this, jerks. Alright, Chosen. We march! change targets. Swivel and shoot. Uzul! Some buff magic going. Hellfire sword. Darkness. Y'all chase them down. Pop the one jet. Go ahead and pop the potion of toughness. No, you don't. Oh wait, that's for now. Like, crap. After them. Got the healing potion. Save the hell cannon. Get away from my chaos dwarves! Little bastards. Shit's expensive. Alright, the Hellcannon's okay. Got a little low there, but it's okay. It's okay. I think one thing I could do to start telling you guys that y'all might enjoy is like what Warhammer book I'm reading at the moment. I just started Master of Death, which was the final book written for the Blood of Nagash series. Subjugate. Yeah, you belong to me now. No one else. You are mine. Alright, so the building here, we want this thing. Upkeep, minus upkeep for all things. Because that will finally put us in a place where I think we can have a 20 stack that doesn't cost us $1 billion. So I'm just going to defend these guys until they're in a better place. I'm going to go ahead and break my alliance with the Naglfari. Not the Naglfari, the Grayling. They are in Naglfari. But I will defend this place with my life for a little bit. Foeseeker. Actually, before I get Foeseeker, let's go ahead and get an Authoritarian. I want to build up that tree. And you're wearing items. Yep. And we don't really have all that much for you. And I'm going to go ahead, Grayling, and break up with
dark
you guys.
Blessings upon you.
Cancel military access. And it's going to be a few turns before we can
speak,
declare war.
You craven car. And pray to whatever.
So I'm gonna deal with the Vark next, but I'm gonna protect these guys for a bit. And then we've got a hell of a war to do in the south. The Isling isn't the best clan to wake up, but they're a decent clan to wake up. Let's do one more turn, and then I'm kind of just trying to wait out the turns that I need before I can go to war with these guys, because I'd rather just wipe out these guys first and then go for the Varg last. Look like the Varg are kind of just derping around. Alright, so that's good. So let's take Aspirations for Greatness. And see if I still get penalties for this.
Diseased dogs, present yourselves so I may put you out of your misery.
Doesn't say. Alright, I'm gonna wait, let's say, 3 more turns. We're just gonna speed through 3 turns. I don't want to buy any more troops, because troops are expensive. Actually, there's one troop I might buy. There's one thing I can think of that could be useful. Oh, Dimitri's discovered. Recruit another chariot? Oh, yes. Yes! And that reduces their upkeep. Yes! Get my knights with lances, yo. Reduces Chaos Knight upkeep by 30%. I'll take it. Alright, so the Isling were defeated. I can't even catch up with Dimitri, unfortunately. He's just going to run away from me until the cows come home. Alright, so we finished the Pillar of Skulls, which is fantastic. He wants me to build another chariot? I can afford one of these. Is that another good guy army? Has to be. Let's go ahead and take our fight to the Grayling. Alright. Let's dance. I should be able to do this without getting in too much trouble. Damn it! Well, I tried. Ah, I waited like 6 or 7 turns. Or maybe it was only like 5. Whatever. Once they're all subjugated, hopefully they'll behave themselves. Cavalry contingent, chariots, and then chosen. Yeah, y'all just defend the war machine. I'll be back. Beautiful shot. Alright, I'm among them. Go ahead and pop the wand of jet. And do duel. Chariots, go time. Chase them. Knights. Break them. Slowly getting a more aggressive army. Rawr. Yes, run through the burning head. My chariots are just like, run away! Archaon's stupid spell chomps us all. Lost a couple knights to that unit of great weapons. But other than that, pretty good. Chariots reap a nice tally. Not as much as the knights, of course, but decent. Sven Groven. You're dead now. Alright, hopefully these guys will be worth something in the realm of sacking. 5,000? I'll take it. That reminds me. What is my deal with this? Oh, it's just to win the battle? How hard is this battle again? It's kinda hard. It's not that hard, it's kind of hard. We're gonna need some more halberds. And by some, I mean a lot. Okay, summon Zarius. Do that, and just give me some... Oh, I don't have access to Chaos Warriors, do I? Nope. Give me some Marauders. I'm gonna need them for this next fight. I'm getting my crown. I need it. The Varg are dead. This bodes poorly. But I've got other things I need to deal with. Intrio, the Chosen of Tzeentch. While any other mortal birth would fear a Lord of Change, Archaon cares little. He knows of these creatures that while they are impressive on the battlefield compared to mundane warriors, it is their arcane might he must vanquish. But when Tzeentch's greater demon is banished back to the realm of chaos, leaving the crown of domination in its wake, then the end times will truly begin. Yes, I would really, really like to have that crown. Oh, speech.
I know my destiny is absolute. Balakor will coronate me. Come then, Changer. Bring your best. I will prove once more that I am the Everchosen. For I am the Anointed, the Bringer of Woes, the one true Lord of Chaos!
Alrighty then. So he's got a pretty monstery army, which Archaon himself can whip the shit out of. And we're gonna have marauders to absorb... I guess we'll come down off the hill, because that'll be better for us. We'll have the marauders absorb the brunt of the attack. Chosen following up behind. You guys will be leading from the second rank. Hell Cannon will position up here. There we go. You guys are going to focus on harassment. Chaos Knights, you will ride. I guess you'll ride with me into the fight. We're just going to go in swinging. Chariots, your job is to reinforce the infantry. That should do it. Ride! Okay, I'm gonna go kick Intrio's ass. Jesus Christ, flee! I want you buggers to just slam into this flank and do as much damage as you can. I go deal with bird breath. Oh shit, we need to get on this hill. To the hill! Up, 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 up! Intrio! Break free. Yeah, fine. I'll deal with you. Turn around. All right, Marauders. Let's get these dragon ogres away from me. Let's reinforce Archaon. Back in there, you weaklings. Need to deal with this demon. Don't think I have the luxury of killing him with Archaon. Our Hellcan's definitely going down. I don't think there's any getting away around that. To me! Prove yourself to me, exalted. Or kill trolls, that's cool too. That hurts! Archaon! Yeah. Down you go, you son of a bitch. Yeah! Alright, Intrio's dead. Buff magic out there. I'm gonna make myself cause fear. Ooh, I'm scary. I'm so spooky. Yeah, you should run away. I would say the Crown of Damnation is ours. Swords of Chaos, defend me! I don't see any other pockets of resistance. Wait. Oh, no, okay. Victory! Alright. The last of the artifacts of chaos are ours. Whew, he did a number on us. We lost our hell cannon. That's not the biggest deal in the world. Lost our chariot. Other than that, we came out pretty okay. We weren't too badly outnumbered, though, just due to the sheer amount of chaos spawn he had, which, of course, got an annoying amount of kills, but... sacrifice or replenish? I will try and enslave them. See if I catch anything. I most certainly did not. But I have the Crown of Damnation, which minus 5% upkeep, we desperately needed that. Passive ability gives leadership buff to everybody. Horde growth, chance to intercept, unit experience for cav units, and some other basic stats. Fantastic. And that also freed up one of my slots. Oh, my healing potion. So we can give that to you. Alright. And then I'm going to park my butt. And I'm going to get rid of these Marauder units. I guess I'm... Maybe I'll keep one. Eh, never mind. Screw it. Fire them. And then I want my Hell Cannon back, and I want a unit of Chaos Chariots. And then I want some knights with lances. Yeah. Yeah. We didn't lose any of the Chosen, so that's good. And I now have all of the Chaos Artifacts, which is excellent, because it's going to make Archaon super scary. Oh, he's attacking. I'm not gonna back him up. I got better things to do with my time. Hooray! The Isling are expanding. I need one more turn to just sit here and heal and recruit. And then we're off to war. In the north, no less. The tribes gather. I was hoping to save the Varg, but whoever is extinguishing the tribes beat me. There. Whoa, what is this? The Eye of Chaos is closed. The Eye of the Gods is closed. Just your sorcerers tell you. No need for affirmation. Witness me. I don't need witness me. That's really expensive. That's a pretty rare event. Normally I like to do it because it's just kind of fun. But, alright, I'm going to plug up this pass. If he wants to... and I will tell our ally here... Oh good, I'm trustworthy again. To take that. Blood for the Blood God! Alright, it looks like we have finally returned to a good spot, army-wise. I still have a whole nother army that I need to create, but other than that, we should be alright. Alright, I'm going after his big army. And I'm going to try and break the monolithic Atam. Katam. Katam. It's a very southern way to say it. Yeah, hopefully he'll hole up here and I can just break his power in a really big fight. I don't know if you can beat it like that. I hope you can. I'm coming for you, buddy. I am coming for you. I think this will be the last fight. Actually, we might go until we subjugate Norsca. He's only got two settlements left. Because the Varg, unfortunately, were wiped out by something. Probably Kislev. But this will provide me with quite a bit of money. And look at that! No horsemen! Hooray! This will be an easy fight. Like, the settlement will have some horsemen pre-made for it, but it won't have many basic horsemen. Alright, our goal is to protect this thing. Alright. Alright, I got more knights. Which is awesome. And then chariots. Which I probably am going to want more of. Away! Oh no, not you. I want the Death Wizard way out here. Archaon's kicking ass, taking names. Let's see if I can break these guys. Horsemasters! Hey, what do you think you're doing? Alright, Chosen. It's time to party. Meanwhile, in Archaon land. Run away, run away! Ow, 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 ow. That was a mistake. That was a terrible mistake. Well, I just murdered one of my own units. All Chaos Knights, return to the field. Ooh, man. Yeah, my chariots are getting whipped. Withdraw, my chariots, withdraw! Get those wolves off my gore beast. Get here. Shoot! Get! Gore beast, get out of here. Knights. Oh, there goes the mass break. Goodness, that was a little bloody, but it wasn't like a 20 stack. I don't think the regular chariot survived. I couldn't tell. It looks like it didn't. Nope, it blew up again. That's fine. Still got a pretty good amount of kills. Gorby survived, which was nice. Archaon with his 250 kills. I love it. Alright, so we're over time, but I think we're going to go ahead and push... Oh, wait. See, okay, so what I still have to do... is okay, so one more chariot and then more knights. So what I still have to do is heal up and then raise the monolith, hope he succeeds in taking the moot, which if he doesn't, then I have to do, and then I also have to raid and then raise, or sack and then raise, the Varg camp for the battle in Norsca to finally be over. Let's see, let's do Penance of Chaos. I'll at least get it. Okay, so I'm gonna raise the Monolith of Catan and then we'll be done for today, I think. But I am glad to see that we didn't, like, get obliterated. I was legitimately worried. Oh, we're so close to this too. I was legitimately getting worried that our Chaos campaign was gonna, like, fail. Like, we were just not gonna finish it because we were taking so much damage from so many sources. It's just ugly. Knights! And now I have enough knights that they can actually charge in with Archaon and actually, like, devastate people. And with the chariots flowing in behind them, that's probably not a terrible strategy. I really wish CA would consider making chariot riding characters for Chaos like there are in Tabletop. Because I really hate having my chariots, like, not supported by a character. Alright, we're just gonna slam into this army and, like, rip it apart. Alright. Pop up first spell. Pop up second spell. And then... Night Charge! Big ol' sprawling fight. You, get out of here. As we break through, we just... As we're going to pop these, just in case these guys were damaged. Oh, that was over quick. Shoo! Shoo, you stupid wolves. It's so nice to have the Swords of Chaos back. Losing them against Sartorial was heartbreaking. It was a good fight. But, like, it was so infuriating to work so hard and then get set back so far. But the good news is we have a level 10 general who I'm probably going to summon once I finish off Norsca, who can kind of lead them. Warrior Bane. That's worse than everything else I have. Alright, so you're level 14. So, let's do Arcane Conduit. Then you are level 8. Inspirational. Keep making those units cheaper to hire, bro. Alright. I know I said I was done, but I'm just gonna go just a little longer. I'm really enjoying this Chaos campaign. But I'm wanting it to hit that point where we're just, like, destroying everything. Okay, so we're gonna just run over here. In camp, and then we want this building for that sweet having a brain fart of reduction and upkeep. Yeah, that's, and plus the unit experience for Cav is like super amazing. See, I built this. Oh, that's what those are. So where's the mana core in? Seeing the... Oh, he's in the Chaos Rift tree. Okay. That makes sense, I guess. See, those two are going back and forth. The Vark Camp's like a nice one though. Oh wait. Oh, okay. You know what? Fuck it. Let's finish what we started. We're gonna finish what we started, kiddos. Our upkeep has been massively... No! Oh, it's Nordland. Alright, well, I will tell him to focus his efforts on defying Nordland until I can get down there.
I will not obey.
I'm gonna pay the Varg of it, the Varg camp, a little visit. And since I'm making positive profit, we're just going to raise it so that we can finish. And this video, it doesn't end up being like a billion years long. And after this, I think it is Beastmen, and then we're back to Skarsnik. So, good times. Alright, this will be a very similar situation. Just a big old charge. The Norskins are now weak enough that this works. You go here. You go here. Wizard dude, go here. Knights. Unleash my legions! Oh shit. Armor. Weapons. Just utter destruction. Ah. And I don't want to use that because it'll probably backfire.
Beat it! Shoot! I said shoot! Oh, don't leave without your present. This will be fun to watch. They're like, yeah, we got away! Oh shit, what's happening? Oh shit, what's happening? Oh god! Oh god! The spell's not doing as much damage as I would figure it would. That wasn't as fun to watch at all. Excellent. Okay, so Norsca is back under our control. We're considered trustworthy, and all the Norskans belong to us, which means that they will never fight each other again. Ugh. Oh, that's right. I'm not going to raise him. I'm going to subjugate him. Yeah, you belong to me now, bro. You're mine. Alright, and with that, I now have control over the Norskins, and I can finally take my war to the land of the Empire. I'll probably create a new general to help me succeed in that goal. That's super annoying. In any event, hope you guys enjoyed watching. We will pick up next time whipping Theodoric, and then we will head this way, and we will burn our way across Kislev yet again. And this time, there will be no one to save him. No, Bertone is already dead. That's nice. So anyway, thanks everyone for watching. Hope you have a great day. Bye.